Coming to the banking space, so in the latest report that you've put out, you see about 30 to 50% upside for some of the large banks and about 25% core PPOP growth. So where is this growth going to come from and what is the rationale behind your write-up?
Market share gain. Because what's happening is that loan growth in India is running at 11 to 12%. So I'm not saying that loan growth will go from 11, 12 to 18, 19, because unlikely, unless state-owned banks start growing. So if you have loan growth of 11 to 12% with a large chunk of the system just not able to lend because state-owned banks do not have the capital and these NBFCs or smallest private bank which is under pressure, they can't lend, they don't have the capital to lend. So the big guys can actually just take away share. So our view is that the asset growth for them will be between 15 and 25, depending on the name we are talking about. And margin structurally should be on an uptrend because you can see the lending spreads moving up because if investors, their banks which are not lending, spreads are moving up. And second is that as bad loan book reduces, the percentage of total margins also expand. So they're seeing, I would expect, I mean, depending on the name, we are talking about 20 to 25% revenue growth. And costs are not going to grow by more than 15, 14%. So net-net, you end up with a pre-provision earning growth of 25%. Depending on, again, name, 22 to 25. I mean, there's literally nothing else in the region which is giving you that kind of pre-provision profit growth. So as I said, it's going to be, the big become bigger.
Yeah.
Both in the bank space and the NBFC space. And the weak will just keep getting weaker.
Okay.
Unless the break point or the turning inflection point could be if the economy starts like just going ripping, which I don't think is the case right now.